Now, government says the 2019 budget to be read on Thursday will help in achieving all 17 sustainable development goals. Now, this will ensure adequate funding of all goals to facilitate its achievement. Chief of Staff Fremor Parris says adequate funding will be made available to accelerate the attainment of the goals. She spoke at the Royal Dialogue on the SDGs under the patronage of the Asantehene Otumfo Osei-Tutu at the Minshia Palace. Nana Yaojima reports.
With 12 years to the deadline for implementation of the SDGs, Ghana lags behind in key areas of health and education. Madam Osei-Opari revealed the goals have further been localized for effective implementation.
Your Majesty, Nananum, distinguished ladies and gentlemen, we have fully localized the SDGs by integrating the goals in the coordinated program for economic and social development policies that was spearheaded by the Ministry of Planning under the leadership of Professor Jambafo. Beyond that, crucially, we have ensured that our national budgets are prepared in line with the SDGs and the resources are aligned to SDG priorities.
Asantehene Otumfo Osei-Tutu II acknowledges the SDGs may seem ambitious, but he insists it is the way to go for accelerated development. He welcomes government's decision to capture the plan in the national budget.
We cannot, as a people, achieve our full potential if a greater number of our people live in abject poverty, do not have adequate food to eat, suffer from diseases, and have no access to quality education. So ambitious as it may seem, we have a collective duty to ensure that we fully implement the SDGs to achieve the desired results. The SDGs present us with the greatest opportunity to transform our nations, to move from poverty to prosperity, from hunger to abundance, and from dependency to independence.
Policy think tank Imani Africa is advocating increased power to the National Development Planning Commission to supervise various ministries in implementation of goal plans. Kofi Bensel is vice president.
The NDPC should own it, and I think that ownership should come with some authority. That's another policy imperative. If they don't have any power to ask the Ministry of Trade that what have you done in furtherance of these goals, or what have you achieved in terms of the aspects that concern you, then really it's nothing, because they can't make anybody do anything concerning this. So ownership should come with a bit of authority.
Meanwhile, stakeholders have submitted a 13-page declaration on the SDGs to the President Akufo-Addo through the Chief of Staff. Otumfo presented the document in honor of late Bosumuru Kofi Annan for the pivotal role he played in adoption of the development goals by the United Nations. Here is a part of the content which addresses youth issues, read by Bompatahine and former diplomat Nana Ifa Appentin.
Please. Gender split and all public sector boards and to pursue and implement affirmative action laws and policies. Urge government to provide sound health facilities so as to ensure that no woman dies from giving birth. Youth, develop an SDGs awareness and engagement unit. Make it available and require that retractional senior secondary, senior high school, and to ensure that teachers are trained to deliver on this.
That was Nana Yaojima's report. You're watching News Desk. We'll be back with more. Do stay.